Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter respiration. In that, we are studying topic energetics of aerobic respiration. When I say energetics of aerobic respiration, it means the amount of energy produced and consumed during aerobic respiration. Let's study and find out. The three major processes that take place in during the process of respiration are: one is glycolysis, the second one is decarboxylic or oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid or pyruvate, and the third one is Krebs cycle, or you can say TCA cycle, which is tricarboxylic acid cycle or citric acid cycle. Now, during all this process of respiration, there are certain amount of ATP or adenosine triphosphate which is consumed, used or invested as well as gained. In this part of the chapter, what we'll try to study is the amount of ATP that's consumed, gained or produced. Let's first start with glycolysis. Now, glycolysis was a process in which one molecule of glucose underwent a series of 11 step reaction, which was glycolytic cycle, and finally formed a molecule of 2-pyruvic acid or 2-pyruvate molecules. Now, during this step, a lot of ATP was generated, a lot of intermediate products were used, a lot of enzymes were related in this. During glycolysis, ATP produced by oxidation of substrate, or you can say oxidation or breakdown of substrate, were 4 ATP molecule or 4-adenosine triphosphate molecule. ATP consumed was 2 ATP. ATP through reduction coenzymes or reductase coenzymes were 8 ATP molecules in totality. Now, the total ATP that was produced during aerobic respiration or respiration using oxygen were, during the process of glycolysis, were total 8 ATP. Now let's talk about oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid. How much amount of ATP that it is related to? It is related to 6 ATP molecule. And the final one, Krebs cycle or the TCA cycle. Now, when I talk about Krebs cycle or TCA cycle, ATP that's produced by oxidation or breakdown at substrate level is total 2 ATP, whereas ATP that is produced from reductase synthetase coenzyme or reduced coenzymes are total 24 ATPs in totality. So now if you sum up all the ATPs that are gained through the process, you will come up to a figure of 38 ATP. Energetics of aerobic respiration. It means the total amount of ATP consumed, used and produced during the process of respiration, including all the three cycles. Now, the first cycle which we'll be talking about is glycolysis, the breakdown of glucose into 2 molecules of pyruvic acid or pyruvate. During this, the ATP that is produced by oxidation at substrate level or by breaking down the substrate is total 4 ATP, whereas the ATP consumed is total 2 ATP molecules. ATP formed by reduced coenzymes, which could be NADP, is total 2 ATP. And finally, ATP that is produced during all this process of aerobic glycolysis or breakdown of glucose in the cell is total 8 ATP. during oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvic acid. Now this is the next step after the process of glycolysis and just before the Krebs cycle. The amount of ATP that's formed is total 6 amount or so total 6 ATP. Now the third step, which is on the third cycle, which is your Krebs cycle or your TCA cycle, which is tricarboxylic acid cycle. Now during this process, ATP produced by oxidation or breakdown or removal of electrons or loss of electrons at substrate level breakdown or breaking the organic compound is 2 ATP. And ATP that is produced by reduction of coenzymes like NADP, FADP, all such is total 24 ATP. Students, what did we go through in this part of the chapter was that during glycolysis or during Krebs cycle or during oxidative breakdown of pyruvic acid, all these processes, there was certain amount of ATP that was produced by the breakdown of coenzymes like NADPH2, which is nicotine amine adenine dinucleotide phosphates. FADP also contributed to some amount of ATP. At the same time, when substrate or organic acids were broken down, some ATP was formed. And we did a totality or the total to find out how much ATP was used, consumed, and at the end, how much ATP is the cycle left with. If you do it, you'll come on down after the calculation of all the ATP, total of 38 ATPs is gained after all these three processes. So I can say in simple sentence that the net gain back of the process of respiration is total 38 ATP. I hope students, you all are very clear about this concept of how ATP is reduced, consumed, and obtained from different sources, that is energetics of glycolysis. Thank you.